Hello learners, a very good day to all. I am Dr. Vishal Sood, teacher educator. In this unit, in the previous lesson, we have studied, we have learned about the community and how community participation is beneficial for improving elementary education or the quality of the elementary education. We have also studied in the previous lesson about how community and parents can contribute towards improvement of elementary education. Now, today we are going to learn about another part of this unit that is related to community and learning resources. How community can aid or can help as a resource of learning for the children, or how community can contribute towards the school improvement. So our today's lesson will orient about certain main points, which you can see on the screen that the main points of today's presentation, today's discussion will be what we mean by community, a revisit of the previous lesson, a small recapitulation of that, what we mean by community. Then we'll discuss about the community resources. What are the different community resources for school education? How community resources can improve school education? Then we will discuss, we will learn about another aspect, that is role of community in development of learning resources. And in the last part of today's discussion, we will deliberate on certain research experiences with regards to community participation in education and how community participation can improve the quality of education, especially at elementary stage, and how community participation can help in achieving the goal of universal elementary education. So our today's discussion will revolve around, will orient about these major points. So first, what we mean by community? As we have already studied, community means a group of people having common interests who work together to achieve a common goal related to welfare of all community members. That means community is a group of people having certain common interests who work along with one another and who work in a cooperative manner, in a coordinated manner to achieve a common goal. The goal of that community is one goal, common goal. And that common goal is related to welfare of all the community members. So that is a community. Now, community is a smaller section or a smaller part of the larger entity called society. So society may have many communities. Society is a broader concept, whereas community is a part of that society. Now the community shares different features. That is, just like a community has a common language, they have common customs, the community has common nature of occupations, and most important, a community has a well-defined territory. So these are the major features that all communities share. Any particular community has common language. They have common traditions. The people belonging to that particular community have common customs, common traditions, and similarly, the nature of occupations in that particular community are, to the more extent or to the lesser extent, the nature of that occupations is common. And the territory or the area in which that community is residing, that area or the territory is well defined. So this is, that is community, group of people working together towards a common goal, having common interest and related to welfare of all the community members. So about this we have studied in the previous lesson. Now we are going to study about the or learn about community resources, what community resources are available with us that can contribute towards the improvement of school education, that can contribute towards the welfare that of the school education, or that can help in improvement of school activities. So community has abundant, a large number of resources, variety of resources which are having educational value. Community has not only those resources which are having social values, but having educational values. That means we can use those resources, we can use that material, we can use those persons or the individuals to impart education to the children. So community has a large quantum, abundance of the resources which can be put to use in the schools for school improvement or for the development of the school. Now, these community resources can be in material or in non-material form. When we talk of material form, that the community resources are in material form, this means we have certain materials just like agricultural fields, just like Anganwadi centers. Local cooperative societies are there in the villages, the banks are there in the villages, the post offices are there in the villages, the village panchayats, gram sabhas are there in the village, gardens are there in the village, mahila mandals have been established in the villages, youth clubs are there in the village, sports club are there in the village, shops are there in the village, religious places are there in the village, different small groups are there in the villages. So this can be, these are the different groups that can be used as a resource for learning. When we talk of non-material form, then we have certain persons in the society, in the community, who are educated, who are professional, who are having specialized skills in their profession. So they are non-material, or those community resources can be termed as the resources in non-material form or human form. So we have a number of resources. We have abundant resources in our community that can be put to use in the schools for the betterment of the school, for the development of the school, for the improvement of the school activities. Now we have discussed many community resources, agricultural fields. We can take the students to the agricultural fields to teach them or to make them learn about how the crops are produced, how the seed gets generated. So all these topics related to the production, agricultural production, for that the agricultural fields can be act as this community resource. Anganwadi centers are there, how the nutritional status of small children, young children is taken care of, that can act as a community resource. Then local cooperative societies or banks, through these we can, how the banking process takes place, regarding this we can teach our students. So these all are the community resources that can be used a number of times and for which no additional infrastructure, no additional financial requirement is needed for the educational purpose. So there are number of resources for improving school education that are available in our community. Now, other community resources in the available in our community are local leaders, educationists, members of civic groups, panchayat executive members, business professionals. Now these people, the educated people, the educationists or the professionals having certain specialized skills in their profession, or the panchayat members, the people who are doing business, they can act as a resource, they can act as resource person to make the students learn in the schools. Their visits can be organized for the schools and they can contribute towards skill development among the students. Local leaders can be invited on occasion, not only on the occasion of different functions or the programs, but in routine manner so that they can make the students learn about different values, how to lead public, or how to create a consensus on different issues. These are the things that can be taught by these people. So these are the human resources which are available in the community and can contribute towards school improvement, can contribute towards the development of different school activities, which will lead to the improvement of quality in elementary education. Then we have locally available reusable materials and varied kind of services, just like labor, knowledge, about the labor we are having, about traditional occupation. So there are locally available reusable materials in the society that can be put to use for providing education to the students. We have knowledge about traditional occupations with the community members. Those community members can be invited to the schools, and their lectures or the style of doing different occupations or using certain special instruments which are traditional in nature, their services can be sought to develop skill among the students. So that is also a resource for us to develop knowledge, understanding and skills among the students about traditional occupations. So this is also a community resource. Then different cultural functions are organized in the society. Different festivals are organized in the society. Marriages are organized in the community. Religious functions or religious proceedings. So different type of cultural functions are organized, festivals are organized. These all functions, these all religious proceedings or marriages are also the source of knowledge. And these can be used as a resource for learning among the students. So when any cultural function is organized by the community, the students can be taught about why this particular function is celebrated. What are the objectives of celebrating that particular function or that particular festival? What values we learn from those festivals? What is the importance of celebrating those festivals? How the brotherhood or the other values, social values and moral values, can be generated through those functions, through those festivals, that can be learned, taught to the students, that can be made understood among the students through organization of these cultural functions. So these cultural functions, festivals and religious proceedings are the community resources that can be put to use for educating the children and bringing among them the awareness and developing among them different moral and human values. So these are the community resources, different community resources which can be used for the development of school activities or the development of the quality of education at elementary stage. Now, when we talk of the community resources, then what is the role of community in development of learning resources? What is the role of community in development of learning resources? You can see on the screen, there are two pictures on the screen. The first one, where it is written elderly wisdom words. Elderly wisdom words means we have elder people, experienced people in the community who by their own experiences, who by their own life experiences can make the younger generation, can make the children aware about many issues. The children can learn many things from those elder people, and those elder people can be invited to the students. So that is the role of community in school improvement. Then another picture is there on the screen, as you can see on the left, on the right side, that different community members and the teachers, they are sitting together, sharing their views, sharing their experiences, and this all is done to develop the learning resources, to prepare the learning resources that can be put to use for improving the teaching learning process, for improving the curriculum transaction procedures in school education. So community has a larger and a wider role in development of learning resources at the school level. Now, how the role of community in development of learning resources? If you see on the screen, the first is keeping regular contact with the schools and the teachers. Now, there must be a close contact of the community with the schools and with the teachers. What are the needs, particular needs, particular requirements of the schools? What are the particular needs of the teachers with regard to teaching learning process, with regard to schooling activities? Those particular needs, those particular requirements of the schools and the teachers must be identified beforehand. And for this, there is a dire need to have a regular contact between the community and the school and the teachers. The community has to keep a regular contact so that the needs of the teachers, schools be identified, and accordingly those resources or those needs can be fulfilled by the community members through different means. Second, we have to identify the problems which are faced by the schools. Is there the scarcity of anything in the school that is hampering the teaching learning process, that is creating a problem in smooth functioning of school activities? Those problems are to be identified, and it is the role of the community members, especially the school management committee, the parent members of those school management committee must identify those problems faced by the school, so that those problems could be resolved, their solution could be found, and those solutions could be implemented, and the teaching learning process and all other schooling activities can be proceeded in a smooth and appropriate manner for the welfare of the student and for the betterment of the school. So this is also a role of community, to identify the problems faced by the schools and to provide a solution for that. Then another role of community in development of learning resources is to conduct survey for community mapping and locating available resources. Now, the community members, the school management committees, the parents should conduct a survey, should conduct community mapping, and they should identify or locate what resources are available in the community, where those resources are available, which can be used for educational purpose. So in survey, the school management committees can help, the parents can help, the local community members can help, and on the basis of that survey, after identification, locating those available resources, on the basis of that community mapping, then we can prepare a village map on the basis of community mapping. Village map means a map of the village identifying or specifying that this particular facility is available in the village at this particular place, and this can be used for this purpose. So that is community mapping. Every, whether it is an agriculture field, as we have already discussed, we have abundant resources in the community which are available. Just like agriculture fields, banks, shops, religious centers, youth clubs, Mahila Mandal centers, or any local industry if available in the village. These are the learning resources for the school which can be put for educational use. So we have to identify, we have to locate and prepare a map. And after preparing the map, we must pinpoint those places which can be used as a learning resource for the schools. So that village map on the basis of community mapping can be prepared, and it is the role of community, it is the role of school management committee to conduct surveys, have community mapping, and prepare a village map which pinpoint, which locate different resources available in our community, immediate society, and can be put to the educational purposes. Other role of community in development of learning resources is to identify places, to identify materials, to identify the persons, or to identify the services in the community that can be used as learning resource for school education. That means which places can be used to provide education to the students, where the students can be taken for visits and they can have some education or have some experiences, educational experiences from those places, just like agricultural fields, banks, post offices. Then the role of community is to identify material available in the community that can be used for educational purpose, where that material is, with whom that material is available, for what period that material can be used by the school authorities. That is also a role of community, and to identify those materials and put that material to educational use is the role of school management committee or the community members. Then another role of the community is to identify the persons, the individuals in the society who can be employed as teachers or educators for certain time, for a smaller time, so that they can impart their specialized skills, or so that they can pass on their specialized knowledge to the students. So those persons, local leaders, local educated persons, educationists, business professionals, they can be invited to the schools to interact with the students, to interact with the teachers, to share their experiences. That will be a learning boon for the students as well as the teachers. So that is also a learning resource. The community has to identify those persons, those individuals in the community. Then what services are available in the community? The community's role is to identify those services. The role of school management committee is to identify those services in the community so that the students can be trained in those services through the different organization of different activities in which those specialized service personnel can be invited to the schools, and they can interact with the students and they can pass on their specialized skills, specialized knowledge to the students. Then another role of community in the development of learning resources is how to mobilize people and organizations for generous contribution, donations, and other kinds of help. That means the role of community or the school management committee is to mobilize people, is to motivate the people, is to bring the people in the line of the school and other organizations so that they contribute generously towards school improvement, so that they donate certain things to the school and provide other kinds of help, either in cash or in kind, to the school, so that the school's sources or school's resources can be enhanced to a larger level. And when there will be generous contribution or the donations from the local people, from the community members, from the community organizations, then there will be a feeling of oneness. There will be much coordination between those people, local people, and the school authorities, and that will contribute towards quality improvement. That will really give a meaning to the education provided in the elementary schools. Then another role of community in development of learning resources is there is a need of continuing a regular liaison with the community and its members for improving school education. That means a regular contact, a regular liaison, a regular relationship must be there between the community, its members, the parents, and the school authorities, so that the school education can be improved, so that the development in school education can be taken to the maximum possible extent. So that means a regular contact, a regular sharing between the community and the school is of utmost importance if we wish to use different resources available in the community for the educational upliftment of the area, for the educational upliftment of the community, and for the betterment of the schools. So this is the role that can be played by the community in development of learning resources, at especially at elementary level. Now, what the research experiences say, what the research experiences has given to us, and those research experiences particularly with regard to community participation in education. The research studies which have been carried out in past or recent past with regard to community participation in education and its importance in the field of education tells us that the community participation, if it will be on the higher side, definitely the quality of the education will be higher. But if there will be lesser community participation, then the school education's quality will be not of the satisfactory level, will not be up to the mark level. In this regard, a study conducted by Govinda and Bandopadhyay in 2010, they conducted a study on local governance in education, and it was found that if the local governance in elementary education will be there, that will lead to bring transparency, that will bring the quality improvement in education. Then another study conducted by Mishra and Garthia in 2013, who studied the role perception of VEC members, Village Education Committee members in Odisha, they found that the VEC members are interested to participate in different activities. Now, but the major problem is how to generate the interest or how to secure their maximum participation in different school activities that needs attention. And it was also revealed by them that the community and community members can contribute a lot towards school improvement, and different resources available in the school can be, even the parents members of the VECs can act as a resource for the development of the school or bringing the school towards a better side. This was found in by Mishra and Garthia in 2013. Then another study conducted in Himachal Pradesh by Anand in 2017, recently, with regard to functioning of the SMCs, it was found that the school management committees can contribute, can give a lot to the functioning of the schools. And if the SMCs will function in a proper manner, they can contribute towards the improvement of quality at elementary stage. A number of problems, although has been highlighted in these studies, but it is a clear thing when any scheme is launched or when any functioning is evaluated, the problems emerge and there are solutions to those problems. But all of the research experiences which we have witnessed in the recent part, number of research studies undertaken in India highlighted the importance of community participation in education and highlighted the issues and challenges in this context. But the community participation has a lot of role, and the community and its resources, different community members can have a different role, varied roles, multifarious roles in improving the school education. The community, the community members, and the material available in the community in varied forms can act as a learning resource for the school that can be used by the school authorities, by the teachers, a number of times, and for improving the education of the children, for improving the educational standards and learning level of the children. And there are no additional investments in securing there is learning resources and making their use in the teaching learning process. No extra investment is required. We just use them, secure the cooperation from the community members, use them in educational situations, use them for teaching learning process, and after using them, those are again returned back to the community, and there is no investment or no expenditure on the utilization of such resources. So that's why the community itself is a learning resource for the schools, and we should exploit, rather we should make maximum and justified and rational use of those resources for the betterment of the school education. So this was all about the learning resources that we can receive from the community and how a community can act as a learning resource for improving the quality of education and for achieving the goal of universal elementary education. So learners, today in this lesson we discussed about the community, what we mean by community, what resources are available with us for the school education, what resources are available in the community for imparting education and for improving the school education. Then we also learned about the role of community in development of learning resources. What role can community play in development of learning resources? Then in the last, we discussed about certain research experiences on community participation in education. So I hope that you have understood about all these points in a better way. You have learned about all these points in a better way. Thank you, learners. Thank you very much. Have a good day.